Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know that about the formation of various molecules depending on the hybridization concept, and now we are going to talk about that what and how the formation of BEF2 takes place with the help of a hybridization concept. So let us talk about it. So now we are going to talk about that how the formation of BEF2 takes place in the concept of that is hybridization that we have got to know in our previous lectures. And let me talk about this one, that is talking about BEF2. So in this case, basically beryllium is the atom that is will be present in the central most of the molecule, and that is what we have to concern with that of the electronic configuration. So now let us understand that how can we write the electronic configuration of beryllium and how does it plays a very important role in basically giving the hybridization so as to form BEF2 molecule. So now let us talk about this. So beryllium is the one which has an atomic number of 4, so therefore I will write it over here as Be4. So I could write it as, that is 1s2 and 2s2. So this is what we could write. But talking about the further thing that we have to mention, that is the atomic orbital also. So this is the one that is present at the outermost shell. So the atomic orbital would be, basically since it consists of s subshell, so s subshell consists of only one orbital, that is this orbital, s orbital. And moreover, we could see that there are basically 2 electrons over here, so therefore there is 1 electron over here and 1 electron over here. So now let us move on with the further part, that is if we observe this one, then since there is no unpaired electron, and since we have got to know about the valence bond theory, and in valence bond theory we have got to know that is since only bond is been formed because of the unpaired electrons, but since there is no unpaired electron that has been present in the beryllium over here, as you would see, so how can it form bond with that of F also? Not even it can bond, it can form a bond with one of the fluorine atom. So obviously what it has to do is it has to make unpaired electrons. So for now, as we could see that since there is no unpaired electron, so therefore this electron configuration that we have mentioned over here, it will be in a ground state. So for which we have to excite it. But the excitation of electrons will lead the electrons to move toward the higher orbitals or the higher orbits which have more energy compared to that of the previous one. So now if you observe, so this electronic configuration, that is 1s2 2s2, can be also be written as 1s2 2s2 2p0. So this is the thing that we are going to write, because in a ground state also we could see that it is 2p0 that has been present over here, and there is no electron in the p orbit. But what if we excite the electron? So that is the main thing that we are going to do. So now in this case, if we observe that the p orbital or the p subshell consists of basically empty orbitals, and that is what I will mention over here as this one, since there is no electron over here. And what if I excited the electron? So for that we have to provide a particular energy, and that particular energy will basically it will excite one of the electrons which are basically in a paired one, it will shift towards the another orbital. So now for which what I am doing is I am exciting the electron. So this orbital will remain the same, only there will be only the change in electrons or the number of electrons that will only be changed because of the excitation. So let me give this that this p orbital consists of, now because of the shifting of electrons here, it has been 2 electrons that were been present in the s orbital, while one of the electron will be shifted towards the p orbital. So let me give it with the help of this blue one, that is one of the electron will move towards the p orbital, while one of the electron it will remain as it is in the same orbital. So this is the thing that we have got. So we have got basically one electron that has been present in s orbital and one electron that has been present in basically p orbital, or specifically if I would say it, then it would be basically px orbital. So this is what we have got. So basically we have got basically now 2 unpaired electrons, one is present in s orbital and one is present in p orbital. So because of the valence bond theory, now also we could say that the 2 fluorine atoms can easily accommodate their places or easily accommodate their unpaired electrons in this orbital. But this is not the thing that we are going to talk about, because this is the concept where we are talking about hybridization. Obviously it will pair in that way, but the thing is it will undergo hybridization also. This central beryllium atom will undergo hybridization, and that is the reason that the atomic orbitals will create the new hybrid orbitals, and that would be involved in formation of a bonding with that of the fluorine atom. So that is what I am going to talk about. So for this case, as we have got to know, that is the two orbitals, that is what we have got, that is one is s orbital and one is px orbital, specifically of beryllium. So let me explain that. So suppose this is the s orbital of beryllium. Now it has been combining with that of the px orbital of the beryllium, so which is belonging to the second shell, if I would say in that manner also. So this is suppose px, and this is of the second shell, and even this is of the second shell, if I am talking about. And now what happens is, whenever they will combine with each other, so this is one orbital, this is one orbital, so after combination they will create two new orbitals, and those new orbitals are So whenever one s and one of the px or one of the p orbital, they combine with each other, they will create two new orbitals. So this is the orbital that I am talking about. So this is the orbital which is basically made up of one s and one px. So therefore, this is what I could call it as sp hybrid orbital. And even this is the what we have got. Even this is what we could call it as sp hybrid orbital. And we have got to know that the concept of the hybridization, and in this case basically these are the two things that we have got. Let me indicate it with this blue one so that we could understand that these two orbitals are of a different but are of the same energy and are made up of one s and one px. So now this s and this px, they will have an energy level which is very close to, or there is no such difference between this s orbital energy and px orbital energy. But whenever they will form a new kind of orbital, that is, this is the new orbital that they have formed, and now the energy level of this and the energy level of this, the both will be the same, and this is what the equivalent energy is being sustained in the overall hybridization or hybrid orbitals. So now this is of the beryllium that I was talking about. And now this would be very much involved in the formation of the bond with that of the fluorine atoms. So now let us talk about that one. So talking about fluorine, fluorine is the one that could be written in the form of electronic configuration, that could be written as, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. So if we consider the outermost shell, then this is the one that consists of s orbital, and it consists of basically p orbital. And the s orbital, as usual, it consists of two electrons, while this one will consist of basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons with one unpaired electron, as you could see over here, and that is belonging to pz orbital. So there are basically two fluorine atoms that would be occupying the, that is, vacant or incomplete half shell, half orbitals of that is beryllium, that is this one I am talking about. So this is the half orbital that is consisting of one electron and one electron each. And now, but this was something, it was related to the excited state, and it was not related to hybridization. But if I observe this one, obviously the s orbital consisted of one electron, while the px orbital consisted also of one electron. And now here will be one electron that will be present in one of the sp hybrid orbital, and here also one of the electron that will be present in the sp hybrid orbital. So making this orbital to have basically incomplete electrons, because they are not paired, they are basically unpaired electrons that they are present over here. So that's the reason that we have to use two fluorine atoms. So in this case, what we have got is, we have got, that is, the pz orbital, which is basically incomplete with the electrons. And talking about the pz orbital, the shape of the pz orbital is what we have did in our previous lecture also, and that is basically, we could write it in this way. It's just a small indication, just as to understand that this is the pz orbital of fluorine, which consists of basically one electron, and that one electron, let me explain it with the help of this one, that is, it consists of, suppose, one electron. So basically we have to use, basically as I have said earlier also, that we have to use two fluorine atoms. So now what we are going to do is, if we have the structure over here, that is for beryllium, what we have mentioned over here, and if we have to mention, that is, the pz orbital of that of the fluorine, so what we can do is, we will now combine that pz orbital of the fluorine with that of the beryllium, and now this is how the mixing will take place. So obviously they will now they will make a bond with this one. So here we have mixed the s orbital and p x orbital, so as to combine. So as mix, we have mixed it. We have basically the reorientation has taken place over here. So in this case, basically one s and one px orbital of the beryllium, they have basically mixed with each other, so as to form that is hybrid orbitals. But talking about the fluorine atoms, the fluorine atom will have a pz orbital that will be combined with that of this sp hybrid orbital, and that is what I could mention over here in this way. So this is suppose the pz orbital of fluorine. So this is one of the fluorine atom that I am combining it with this one, so as to form a bond. And here the electron of this fluorine, now they will basically they will form a bond. But the thing is, the bond that will be formed, it will be that is a covalent bond. The reason behind that is obviously this sp hybrid orbital of the beryllium and this pz orbital of the fluorine, they will that is overlap with each other in coaxial manner, and that is what a sigma bond has been formed. So meanwhile, if I am talking about the another fluorine atom, that is what we have to introduce, and even the shape of the pz orbital it will is very easy to understand, and that is what we have did in our previous lectures also. Suppose this is the just a short diagram that I am mentioning about the pz orbital of the another f atom, and again it consists of one electron, and this is how the pairing takes place, and again the overlapping is basically coaxially, and that's the reason the sigma bond has been formed. So basically I could say that the bond that has been formed is basically a sigma bond between beryllium and that of the fluorine. But now talking about the geometry and the bond angle. So since in this basically the central atom, basically the beryllium, was exhibiting the sp hybridization, and we know that the molecule or the atom which is showing the sp hybridization, and overall the molecule will have a specific geometry or have a specific bond angle. So because beryllium is the one which is giving sp hybridization, so therefore the geometry, it would be expected to be a linear geometry. So this is how we could say that the geometry is very linear, and talking about the bond angle, the expected bond angle, it has been basically 180 degrees. So that is the reason that here also the expected value of the bond angle, if you could say, it would be 180 degrees. So that is what the structure of BEF2 is, and we have mentioned the earlier things like that of the ethyne also, which was regarding the same concept of hybridization that we have did in our previous lecture. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have to got to know the various concept behind this one. So I hope you will share this video with the friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much.